Hello students, welcome to Evaluation IAS. In our TWR series, let's have a look at the topics of set 2, that is environment. These are IUCN red list. We will start with IUCN today itself. In just one single video, we will cover it. Then we'll have treaties, conventions with recent updates, then organizations and legislation concerned with environment. UPSC in 2019 asked 6 to 7 questions from just single topic like environmental legislations. Then we'll have Ramsar sites, conservation efforts like biosphere reserves, tiger reserves and all. We'll have the list, then some current additions with miscellaneous topics. So let's start with okay. So what is IUCN? Does it have some UN connection? No. IUCN is basically an NGO working for nature conservation and sustainable use of natural resources, headquartered in Switzerland. So IUCN के different status में क्या क्या है? See, it is LC means least concern. Then we have critically endangered, then extinct. Extinct have two categories. One is your extinct in wild, but they are in captivity somewhere. Another is completely extinct. No even a single record available. You can have a look at the different criteria and the definitions. So you can make a pause and you please read these all through. These are very important. So let's move to the IUCN list. So guys, to start with, we have the India's largest land carnivore, that is your Himalayan bear. Just hold on. Yeah, so Himalayan brown bear. So status is critically endangered and it is not endemic to India, but you can find it in Nepal, Tibet, North India, like states of Jammu Kashmir, then northern Pakistan. Okay, so just hold on. Yeah, so now we have pygmy hog. Pygmy hog is, as of now, it is found only in Assam, though in Manas Wildlife Sanctuary. So it's a very unique pig. It builds nest and its movement is nocturnal, and it is world's smallest pig. Okay, so just hold on. Yeah, so earlier it was not only in India, but in Nepal, Bhutan and all, but due to poaching, habitat destruction, this species stay in terai grasslands of Manas Wildlife Sanctuary. So UPSC from one single species can frame 3-4 statements, then they will ask you to eliminate those. So you must not see that like that, which topic, which species is in critically endangered, which is vulnerable. No, you prepare it well, from its habitat to its distribution to its status like critically endangered. Now move to the next one. So now we have Andaman white-toothed shrew. Status again, it is critically endangered, and distribution, it is endemic to southern Andaman islands. So actually, I request you need to focus on those species that are in use, and also those who are critically endangered. So it is endemic to southern Andaman island. It means that you can't find this species in Kerala, Tamil Nadu or any state of India or anywhere else in the world. So now next is your Kondana rat. Recently you must have seen this movie Tanaji. In Tanaji there was a mention of Kondana fort, and this rat is found on that singer plateau only. So have a look at the status. It is critically endangered, and again it is nocturnal. Nocturnal means its movements and all is in night only, and it is found only in India. So you can say Kondana rat is endemic to India only. Okay, and its habitat is subtropical dry deciduous forest. What kind of forest you can expect in that part of Maharashtra? This it is dry deciduous and shrub. So major threats are habitat loss and all. So just keep one thing in mind, for most of the species the habitat threats are basically common to all. Okay, habitat loss, overgrazing, poaching and all. So let's move to the next topic. Now we have Namdafa flying squirrel. As of now, found only in Namdafa tiger reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. UPSC in 2018 asked one question: where is Pakke tiger reserve located? So UPSC won't ask questions from relevant topics. UPSC will ask questions from these only topics. So please keep revising these relevant stuff so that you can clear the cutoff. So have a look. This Namdapa flying squirrel status is critically endangered and habitat is tropical forest. Okay. Found only in Namdapa Tiger Reserve. So it is endemic to Arunachal Pradesh only. So next is your Malabar civet. It is, as per IUCN, it is critically endangered and again it is endemic to India and reported in Kerala. So again it is nocturnal and found exclusively in Western Ghats. So these are both are same. So habitat is your plains as well as the hilly slopes of evergreen rainforest. Earlier you saw that that Kondana rat and all, those are in dry deciduous forest. So you need to focus on these areas also, because when there will be multiple statements, your job gonna be difficult if you have not prepared in this kind of detail. So now move to the next. Now we have one very important species, like we have Kashmir stag. We say it's hangul. So it is sub species of red deer. Now you can find hangul in Chamba, Dachingam National Park in Jammu Kashmir. And one more important thing, it is state animal of Jammu Kashmir. So status is critically endangered. So now move to the next. Now we have, just hold on for one second. I need to check whether it is critically endangered or endangered. So we'll make a pause, we'll come back. Yeah, hello. Thankfully it is critically endangered. So I had some confusion, so I checked it, because these are factual stuff, but we can't afford to take it wrong. So now next is your red panda. Very beautiful but under threat. So but yeah, recently we have some news. Red panda has been moved from vulnerable to endangered category by IUCN. Now note one thing, that red panda is endemic to the temperate forest of Himalayas. And the states, have a look at the states where you can find the red panda. It would be Sikkim, Assam and northern part of Arunachal Pradesh. Only three states, like Sikkim, Assam and northern part of Arunachal Pradesh. But recently, as a homework, please do it. In the Hindu it came that red panda was found in another northeastern state of India. Please do me a favor and cover it as your homework. So what are the threats? Threats are habitat loss, fragmentation, poaching, as I told you earlier. But one more important thing, threat is inbreeding depression. It's due to mating of the related individuals, and this panda is facing population loss due to this inbreeding depression. Now next we have wildlife, or we say khur. It is found in the state, found in the states of Gujarat. So as of now, most of the population occurs in run of Kutch. It is a last refuge of wildlife. Okay, but good news is that population is increasing. So status is not critically endangered, but it is NT, or we can say near threatened, right? So move to the next. Now we have dhol, or we can say Asiatic wild dog or Indian wild dog. So guys, where you can find this species? It's not critically endangered. Dhol is found in the central Indian highlands of like Madhya Pradesh, Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats and some southern state. So south of Ganga, anywhere you can find this dhol. Also in Northeast India, they inhabit Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya and West Bengal. Nice. Move to the next. Now we have elk deer, or you can say thamin or bro antler deer. Its distribution in Kaibul Lamjo National Park in Manipur. Threats are very common. So please comment as a homework, what is the IUCN status of elk deer? It's not critically endangered. Check it whether it is vulnerable or endangered, because I hope you all are noting it down, because that is the most important. You can't rely completely on video. You will have to do some hard work. Please do it. Next is your golden langur. It is vulnerable. and distribution is in Assam as well as neighboring foothills of Black Mountains of Bhutan. So golden langur is not endemic to India. It is not found only in India, because UPSC in MCQs will throw some traps like whether it is found only in India or not. So please have a look. Golden langur is found along with Assam in Bhutan mountains also. So now next we have Himalayan white-bellied musk deer. Habitat is Kashmir, Kumaon areas of Uttarakhand and Sikkim. Threats are again common, but poaching is very high. But only males produce the musk. Okay, I think its Hindi name is Kasturi heron. So next we have Hispid hare or Assam rabbit. As per IUCN, it is endangered. Hispid hare from Assam is endangered as per IUCN. Habitat is southern foothills of central Himalaya. Habitat destruction, threats due to agriculture, some constructions and all. We have hog deer. Where it is found? Grasslands of North India. You must have read about grasslands. Please comment if you know grasslands from India. Terai region of North India. Threats like hunting, poaching, fragmentation of habitat, encroachments. Threats are common, and in MCQ you hardly find the questions with threats. Now we have LTM, lion tail macaque. It is endemic to Western Ghats. Some features you can read about, they avoid human presence and all, but their habitat is restricted to evergreen forest. You can find them in Kerala. Okay, so they stay around these plantations, but the same plantations, the spread of same plantations is a threat nowadays for these lion-tailed macaques. So please comment in which of the states is lion-tailed macaque is found in its natural habitat, whether it is Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka. Please comment. Now move to next. We have Chiru or Tibetan antelope. So it is endemic to this region. It is near threatened, not critically endangered, neither vulnerable. It is near threatened anti, found in Tibet cold desert, thread due to its wool. Okay, that is used to make shatush scarves for meat and the magnificent horns you can see. Have a look. So now next is vulnerable. As per IUCN, it is Nilgiri langur. Nilgiri langur is vulnerable as per IUCN, and its habitat is around Tamil Nadu and Kerala, hilly areas, not plains, but hilly areas of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. We'll move to the next. Now we have Nilgiri tahar. One very beautiful story I will tell you. First of all, have a look at the status. As per IUCN, it is endangered, not vulnerable, not critically endangered. It is endangered as per IUCN. So it is protected under Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act 1972. And guys, Nilgiri tahar is the largest of all the tahar species. We will see about Himalayan tahar also. So habitat area of Nilgiri tahar is mountain grasslands of Western Ghats, Nilgiris, and it is state animal of Tamil Nadu. So regarding a story, I will tell you that in my class 6 I had a story regarding friendship of Todas and Tahar. Todas are tribes inhabiting Nilgiri areas, and Tahars, there was a very good story about this one. So I remember Toda plus Tahar, so you can remember T square. So Todas are found in that region, along with them Tahar are also found. So now next, we'll have a separate video on tribes in India. So please keep on supporting us. Your one sharing, one like, your one comment is like oxygen. So please, yeah, now have a look at the endangered marine mammals. So UPSC in 2014 prelims asked few questions on from this topic. So now have a look. Freshwater or river dolphins. So distribution of these dolphins, just hold on, yeah, it's in not endemic to India but in Bangladesh, Nepal and Pakistan also. Two subspecies, one is your Indus, there are two different names. One is Bhulan. Bhulan we say for this Indus dolphin, and Susu we call for, basically these both are blind. Susu is called is dolphin from your Ganges. Threats are due to fishing gears, habitat loss, degradation, large constructions, barrages and all, embankments, pollution, industrial waste and all. Sorry. So these Ganges river dolphin, have a look at the habitat. They are inhabiting the rivers and tributaries of Ganga and Brahmaputra. One more important thing, Ganges river dolphin is a national aquatic animal of India. Fine. So habitat you already know. For Indus river, river dolphin, Indus river in Pakistan and bees. So this Indus river dolphin is not found only in Pakistan but it is found in India also, in the tributaries of Indus like Bees and Satluj. Rivers and tributaries, will have a playlist later on. So now move to the next. So yes, Susu and Bhulan shares its habitat with crocodiles, freshwater turtles and all. So we are done with this topic. Next is your Gaur Indian bison. I think it was 2011 UPSC, they asked question on Indian bison. So have a look, they are bovines, large bovine native to South Asia. Sorry guys, yes they are Indian bison, large bovine native to South Asia. See, their habitat is evergreen forest along with semi-evergreen and also moist deciduous. So please have a look at the categorization. They are not found only in deciduous, semi-evergreen, but in all three. Okay, so, and also occurs in deciduous forest, deciduous, moist deciduous, semi-evergreen, evergreen forest, almost everywhere. Okay, so IUCN status is vulnerable. And recently in 2020 October, if I'm not wrong, we were preparing the list for our students in October. They were in news due to some poaching, some habitat fragmentation. What was the reason, I don't know, but it was in news. So it is important for this year. Gaur or Indian bison, IUCN status vulnerable. Now habitat, you saw it. Now move to the next. We have Great Indian one-horn rhinos. So as per IUCN, these are vulnerable, and as of now they are found only in the grassland areas or foothills of Himalayas, we can say Tarai regions. We have the list of the national parks where you can find Great Indian rhino, or you can say one-horn rhino. These are Kaziranga National Parks, Pobitura Wildlife Sanctuary, Manas National Park of Assam. One recent update is there. We have some good news. This Great Indian rhino hasn't moved from endangered to vulnerable, right? From endangered to vulnerable. Okay, so it's a very good news. It's all thanks to the consistent efforts of the NGOs, Environment Ministry, conservation heroes. So now we have four horned antelope, or we can say Chausinga. So this four horned antelope, this is just a story. They must drink water, pani nahi piyenge to mar jayenge, ab ye MCQ mein to nahi aayega. So yeah, now as per IUCN they are vulnerable. Distribution, as of now they are present confined to Indian subcontinent. So you can say ki they are found only in India, they are endemic to India. Four horned antelope or Chausinga as of now are endemic to India, because they are not found anywhere else in the world. Okay, come to the status, habitat of this Chausinga or four-horned antelope. Scattered between foothills of Himalayas in the north of Deccan Plateau. So yeah, one thing about Gujarat's Gir National Park. Gujarat Gir National Park hosts around 1200 Chausingas. So it's a very good conservation effort from Gir National Park. Now next, it is Takin. Recently, IUCN updated its status. See, as per IUCN, it is vulnerable. But it is endangered in China, but vulnerable in India as per IUCN. Look at the habitat. They inhabit Himalayan mountains and the western China. So they are not endemic to India. I mentioned China also and India also. So next is your Oriental small clawed otter or Asian small clawed otter. So have a look. Actually, why I introduced pictures and all, it is taking too much space and all, taking lots of time. Believe me, this pictorial memory of every species that you are revising, it will stay for a longer time. You are revising, you may revise from Shankar IAS, you may revise from any good notes, every book is okay. PMF IAS is also a great source. But believe me, if you can revise using such kind of pictures, slides and all, along with some voiceover, so you can retain it for a longer time. It is scientifically proved thing, so you can revise this video again and again. So now your Oriental small clawed otter or Asian small clawed otter, these are semi-aquatic mammals feeding on fish, shellfish and some more species. It is the smallest otter species in this group. So where, just hold on for a second. So yeah, they inhabit mangrove swamps and freshwater wetlands. For both of these topics, we'll have video. Mangroves and wetlands in the Ramsar series, we will have it. As per IUCN, they are vulnerable. They are not critically, otters are in India, are not critically endangered, neither endangered, they are vulnerable as per IUCN. Now next is your clouded leopard. It was in news multiple times in the Hindu last year. So habitat is your Himalayan foothills through mainland Southeast Asia into China. So clouded leopard is not endemic to India. It's very natural because those upper reaches of Himalayas, these clouded leopard inhabit. So they also occur in West Bengal. So it's unique thing. Clouded leopard, though they stay in those upper reaches of Himalayas, they also stay in West Bengal, Sikkim, Arunachal, Manipur, Mizoram, almost entire Northeast. So as per IUCN, they are vulnerable. As per IUCN, clouded leopards are vulnerable. So just hold on for a second, guys. Sorry. Now, okay, so we are done with clouded leopard. Now move to next. We have Asian black bear, moon bear, you can see white chested bear. So ye bears jo hain, as per IUCN, they are vulnerable. Habitat is Himalayas, Korea, Northeast China, Russia's forest. You know, Russia's forest was in news last year. Why it was? Due to some resource explorations, India was showing interest, so that's a part of higher lecture, we'll cover it up. So threats are deforestation, hunting for body parts and all, captivities. Next is your Murkhorse. Murkhorse, recent update is there. Murkhorse moved from endangered category to near threatened category. So we'll have a look. It is it is national animal of Pakistan. Murkhorse are national animals of Pakistan. They're also found in the upper districts of Jammu Kashmir. Threats are hunting for both meat and its horns. You can see, have a look. Next is your black buck, the great Salman Khan. So black buck was in news. Distribution almost in Indian subcontinent. You can find in deserts, coastal areas, mountains in the northern and northeast also. So there is not any endemic like thing ki it is present in south part, western part. So it is available in these all areas also. Habitat, grasslands, deserts, coastal areas. Threats due to meeting and sporting trophies. पता नहीं सलमान भाई को कौन सा ट्रॉफी जीतना था बेचारे को. सो नाउ दिस ब्लैक बक, यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड दिस ब्लैक बक और चिंकारा. आई थिंक दिस बोथ आर सेम चिंकारास. सो जस्ट होल्ड ऑन, माई अपोलॉजीज स्टूडेंट्स, दिस ब्लैक बक्स एंड चिंकाराज आर टू एन एक्सटेंट आर डिफरेंट. वेलकम टू दैट. सो माई अपोलॉजीज, आई मस्ट नॉट मिस गाइड यू. येस, सो ब्लैक बक्स आर स्टेट एनिमल ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश. एक्चुअली ब्लैक बक्स एंड चिंकारा आर लाइक यू नो वेरी रिलेटेड बट नॉट द सेम. नाउ मूव टू नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. That is your Himalayan Tahar. We are all done with the Nilgiri Tahar. We heard that Todas and Tahar are how much related they are. But there is a difference. Himalayan Tahar are threatened as per IUCN. Habitat is, of course, it's Himalayas. The major threats in China. So, China is there. It means that Himalayan Tahar are not endemic to India. But actually Himalayas, wherever Himalaya you will find Himalayan Tahars. Upper reaches of Himalayas. So threats are due to uncontrolled hunting, deforestations, hunting for meat. So next topic is your, now we'll have look at the birds like Jordan Cougar, Owlet, White-bellied Heron, Bengal, Florican's and all. So first we have Jordan Cougar. Jordan Cougar, these are nocturnal, found only in the northern part of the state of Andhra Pradesh. So it's very important. Now in Sri Lanka Maleshwara Wildlife Sanctuary, you can note it down. So these are endemic to your Andhra Pradesh. You must have heard Mahesh Babu. So now habitat is undisturbed scrub jungles and in open areas. So they are not found in those evergreen forest and all. So please put a stress on these all important areas so that you don't miss anything that is important, because UPSC may ask a very simple question like Jordan Cougar birds are critically endangered as per IUCN. They are found in which of the following states of India? Arunachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh. So if you know, you can take it right. But if UPSC will frame around two statements or maybe three statements, then what you will do? You'll have to revise it in such a way that you can bit cold guys, so that's why communication is not that proper. So please pardon me for that. So threats as usual, illegal trapping of birds for food and all, plantation of exotic trees, degradation of habitat, quarrying, mining, construction of river canals, same things. These are Jordan Cougar are critically endangered as per IUCN. Now next is your forest owlet. So they are endemic to central Indian forests. So yes, and as per IUCN they are not critically endangered, but they are endangered. So and habitat is your dry deciduous. So what kind of forest you can expect in central India? Naturally it's dry deciduous forest. Habitat is south of Madhya Pradesh and northwest Maharashtra, northern central Maharashtra. Threats are logging operations, burning, cutting of trees and all. Now next bird is white-bellied heron. Distribution, they are extremely rare bird found in the 5 or 6 sites of Assam, Arunachal, also in Bhutan. So we got the point, they are not endemic to India. Along with these two states, they are found in Bhutan as well as in Myanmar. Habitat is river with sand. So one thing you have find, UPSC will frame questions such like that. A bird X or ABC is found in the riverine areas with sand and all. So it is found in these states. UPSC will frame a complete paragraph, then it will give you options. Sometimes UPSC makes your job easy. So if you can prepare in such a way, then nothing can stop you getting those 2 to 4 marks for sure. But they are critically endangered due to destruction of habitat, poaching, hunting for food and all. So Now we'll have the next bird. We have Bengal Florican. UPSC, I don't remember the year, but in PYQs you can find this question regarding Bengal Florican. So it is a rare bustard species that is very, we'll have a map of India showing different bustard species. So these Bengal Florican are rare bustard species that is very well known for its mating dance. So habitat, these Bengal Floricans inhabit grasslands. Okay, so though they are Bengal Florican, but they are not found only in Bengal. In fact, they are not found in Bengal. See, neither they are endemic to India as they are found in Cambodia, Nepal. So in India, you can see they are found in only these states. Sorry for my words, I said ki they are not only found in Bengal. In fact, they are not even found in Bengal. Bengal Florican are not even found in Bengal. Rather, they are found in your, just hold on. Yes. They are found in Uttar Pradesh, Assam and Arunachal. They are critically endangered. Bengal Florican is critically endangered. Ho sakta hai Bengal mein milta hoga, hum gayab ho gaya. But yaad karo, they are critically endangered. Found in just three states as well as Cambodia and Nepal also. Next is Himalayan quail. Again, they are critically endangered. Habitat is tall grasslands and scrub on steepy hillsides. Distribution is western Himalayas, not the eastern part of Himalaya, but western part of Himalayas. So just hold on. Yeah, threats are hunting, poaching and all. I think you guys are bored with this threat option. Now next is your sociable lapwing. They are migrants, winter migrants. So, and they are critically endangered, right? So, and they inhabit the scrub deserts. And distribution, basically they fly from Central Asia, like somewhere near to Caspian Sea. In the map series, you must have heard of Caspian Sea along with the Trix. So yeah, Russia, Egypt, India, Pakistan. So these are the areas where this sociable lapwing stays. In India, the habitat is restricted to north and northwest of the country. You can't find sociable lapwing in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, but in the northernmost and northwestern part of the country, they are not found either in northeast. Fine. So next is your spoon-billed sandpiper. They are critically endangered and they were in news. They were in news in 2020, somewhere in June or July. In the Hindu they came. So you must have a look at this topic. So spoon-billed sandpiper. See, India is home to the last existing wintering ground for this species. Okay. So where do they inhabit? These are the coastal areas. Coastal areas of India, like this, you know, sorry, this eastern part. Yeah. So these eastern parts of India, West Bengal, Odisha, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, these spoon-billed sandpiper you can find. Threats are, you can have a look because you are also bored, too much repetition of the same thing. So now next is Siberian crane, very important topic. They are one of the largest migratory birds, breeds in winter in wetlands. They are known to migrate in winter in the Keola Dev National Park. Where is it? It is in Rajasthan. Again, they are critically endangered. Where you can find them? You can find them in the wetland areas of this park or the nearby areas. Threats due to pesticide pollution and wetland drainage. Next, you have critically endangered reptiles, Ghadiyal, CAC 2017. Why I am giving reference to CAC pasture papers? Because you must know that how important these topics are. Multiple times UPSC has asked questions, so you can't afford to miss this list. No matter, you can cover it from anywhere else also, but it's an endeavor to provide you the best that I can do. So critically endangered reptiles, first we have the Ghadiyal. They are very unique. They stays in clean waters with sandbanks. Distribution, you can find only in the National Chambal Sanctuary. Okay, and one most unique thing regarding National Chambal Sanctuary, it's not it does not lie in just one state, rather you can find it in three states: Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. The small non-breeding population of the same species you can find in the tributaries of Ganga: Son, Gandak, Hooghly, Ghagra. Earlier they used to exist in Myanmar, Pakistan, but unfortunately it's not the case anymore. Threats, please have a look: sand mining, livestock issues, riverine habitat destruction. Okay, next you have hawksbill turtle. As per IUCN, they are critically endangered. Believe me, they are migratory in nature and they nest across 70 countries across the world. Okay, they make nest in the sandy beaches. Distribution: they are found in Andaman Nicobar Islands, Tamil Nadu coast and Odisha. So you can have a look, these areas here you can find. Okay, Tamil Nadu, Odisha and all, Andaman Nicobar. So distribution, you saw IUCN status: hawksbill turtle, they are critically endangered and they are migratory. They are not endemic to India, rather they are migratory. Next we have the leatherback turtle. Sorry for the mistakes that we have done here, it would be leatherback. Leatherback, you can have a look at the spelling, please check the Google. Extremely sorry for this whatsoever happened in the Hindu, February 2021. This species was in news. So these are the largest of the living sea turtles. Okay, they inhabit the tropical and subtropical oceans, tropical as well as subtropical oceans. As per IUCN, they are not critically endangered, but they are vulnerable. Distribution: found in tropical and subtropical waters, temperate waters of Atlantic, Pacific, also into Indian Oceans. So these three oceans you can see: Atlantic, Pacific and Indian Oceans. Threats, you can have a look. Artificial lighting is a unique thing. So due to artificial lightings, this disorients the hatchlings and adults. They do migrate from the other areas and they do migrate to the inner parts of the coastal areas, and they become more vulnerable to the threats. Okay, we are done with this leatherback turtle and hawksbill turtle, ghadial. Next we have olive ridley. Olive ridley, CSE 2014. Olive ridley, they are also known as the Pacific ridley turtle. In UPSC prelims, if there is a statement that they are also known as Indian Ocean turtle because they come in India, Indian coasts, not so is the case. They are also known as Pacific ridley sea turtle, found in warm and tropical waters, primarily in Pacific and Indian Ocean. It doesn't mean that they are only in Pacific and Indian Ocean. They can be found in other oceans also, but mainly they are in Pacific and Indian Oceans. Fine. So in Indian Ocean, the majority of olive ridleys nest near Gahir Matha in Odisha. Fine. In this context, tell me, where is your Rishikulya beach and why it is famous? Rishikulya beach was in news in Hindu recently. Why it is famous? Please do comment. We have a difference between turtle and tortoise. You can pause the video and look at the difference, like turtle lives in water, tortoise live in land. These are herbivores, but these are carnivores. You please take a pause and read, have a note. Now we have few sharks. They are critically endangered. First is your Pondicherry shark. They are critically endangered. Distribution: Indian Ocean, from the Gulf of Oman to Pakistan. So they are not endemic to India. Fine. So they have also been recorded in Hooghly River. They are Pondicherry shark. It doesn't mean that they stays close to Pondicherry only. So threats are commercial fisheries and all. Now we have Ganges shark. This is important. So they stay in turbid waters of Ganga River and the Bay of Bengal. So they have some biological adaptations. So they have very small eyes to make some adjustment in the turbid water. Okay. So distribution: India as well as in Pakistan. The Ganges River system and Hooghly River mouth are known as its habitats. It is critically endangered. It's not officially extinct. It's fine. So next you have your, yeah, we missed it actually earlier. We made the slide later on. So you have lion and tiger in the same slide. Lion is vulnerable as per IUCN trades and some poaching and all. But tigers are endangered, and we have some good news. Please Google it. The report of the recent tiger status, some news in past couple of months was there regarding some tigers and Royal Bengal tiger. Tiger census was being conducted. So we will, in our test series, we will frame questions from this area. So as of now, as a homework, please find the states where lions and tigers are found. So now we have black neck crane. We missed it earlier, so we have added these all things later on, so that you do not miss anything that is significant. So now status of black neck crane, BNC, is vulnerable. So there is a news in Tawang, Arunachal Pradesh. There was a project that was halted due to locals who protested. Otherwise, this habitat was under threat due to that project. So locals and conservation specialist NGOs protested, and that project was halted. So the species breeds on the Tibetan Plateau. They are inhabitants of Tibetan Plateaus. They are endemic to that plateau, but they migrate to Tawang in Arunachal for winter. So the bird, they are mostly found in China. Okay, legally protected in Bhutan. So just hold on. So yes, so they are legally protected in Bhutan and India also, not in China. Kya matlab unko NGO se. So they are considered sacred to certain Buddhist sects traditions. So this is the most important thing. Which bird? Your black neck crane. A status is vulnerable. Tawang, Arunachal Pradesh, originally from Tibet, but sacred to certain Buddhist traditions. Now have a look at the map. CSE 2016 prelims. One question was related to, if you know this map, you can solve that question. We have three bustards. Your great Indian bustard. Here you can have a look. Here. So there, great Indian bustard is not found only in this Rajasthan, but other parts of Gujarat, your Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu also. And the lesser florican, not that significant, but they are found here. And this Bengal florican, except Bengal, they are found everywhere. Uttar Pradesh, this Arunachal Pradesh that we discussed already. So yeah, finally we are done. Now the next video in this series will come for this same topic, just maybe 15-20 days before prelims, or 1 month before prelims, regarding species in news. One video of 30-40 minutes covering all species in news, covering all significant sources. So what would be the next in this playlist? It would be your treaties, conventions with 2021 updates. Thank you very much for supporting us, for watching us. Please, if you like the video, please share it with your friends. Please comment where we can improve. Please revise it multiple times so that you can ensure one or two questions in the prelims. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video.